cooperative effort between the City of Lacey and Olympia, and its purpose is to put Class A reclaimed water into the groundwater flowing under Woodland Creek. Class A reclaimed water is water that is so clean we can do almost anything with it except drink it. It's cleaner than the water that comes from Long Lake and becomes Woodland Creek. The reclaimed water used in this facility comes from the Lot Clean Water Alliance Treatment Facility on Martin Way. Their sewage is treated to a very high level to produce this resource. It then travels via pipeline down Carpenter to the Woodland Trail and then east to this location. The recharge facility here consists of 4 acres of infiltration galleries where the reclaimed water soaks into the ground at a controlled rate. The goal is not to have reclaimed water end up in Woodland Creek. Instead, it flows through the soil under the creek, reducing the amount of creek water that is naturally lost to the ground as it flows down through the creek bed. The end result is more water in Woodland Creek for both fish and other aquatic life. Lacey, Olympia, and the City of Yelm work together with the Washington State Department of Ecology to secure water rights for our growing cities. Lacey and Olympia, specifically, needed to mitigate predicted impacts to Woodland Creek from the future use of these water rights. This facility is designed to fully mitigate the predicted flow reduction. It is an example of a winning partnership where cities are able to continue to provide water service to their growing populations while leaving Woodland Creek unharmed.
The dedication of this facility today is the culmination of a multi-year effort by Lacey, Olympia, Yelm, Ecology, the Washington Department of Fish and Wildlife, the Squaxin Island Tribe, the Nisqually Tribe, and others to ensure that our water resources and in-stream flows in the Nisqually and Deschutes River basins are protected. More importantly, that these water resources are protected for future population growth, for fish migration and habitat, and for the various economic needs for water supplies such as farming and industry.
At the moment, we're infiltrating about 900,000 gallons a day. In the winter time, it is reduced because of the higher groundwater, and it goes to about 300,000 gallons per day. We have 3 infiltration galleries, and we infiltrate only 1 gallery at a time and allow the other 2 to rest. So once it infiltrates, Julie can explain a little more.
Well, let me step back and talk a little bit about the groundwater modeling that was done to support this project. So from the beginning, we used a groundwater model to predict what the surface water impacts would be at full use of the exercising of water rights from Lacey, Olympia, and Yale. And so that gave us an idea of what the impact to surface flows would be. And so using that, that was the basis for the design for this project. So we had to do infiltration studies to ensure that the site would be feasible for infiltrating the quantity that would be needed. We also knew that what we put in the ground is not necessarily what's going to come out in the stream. They actually modeled, like, it's very seasonally, in between 58% and 85% of what's infiltrated here actually will migrate eventually to Woodland Creek and discharge about 1 mile after 3-year travel time. So that's the kind of stuff that goes into the design of the project to give us an idea of the quantities that we need to infiltrate, when we can best infiltrate it, because that's all based on groundwater levels. You can't infiltrate a lot of water when the groundwater levels are high, and it can infiltrate a lot more during the summertime when it's very low. So the basis of this is the model. And so what we're trying to do is prove out the model. So during the first year of operations, we're comparing what we've infiltrated against what the model predicted. And the good news is that the model didn't underpredict what this facility can do. We were actually able to infiltrate more in the summertime than what the model said, and we were able to do at least and possibly a little bit more during the wintertime. And of course, it's going to take several years of operation to see, you know, over the long term, what can it really do. But the good news is that it's doing what it was originally intended to do, which is to support the groundwater that actually provides the base flows into Woodland Creek. There's just no way of really knowing exactly how much goes into the creek. But we have had a long-term monitoring program in Woodland Creek, and we'll just continue doing that on a monthly basis and seeing if there's any changes to flows, levels, water quality, that sort of thing. So there's a lot of work that put in the initial part, the design, the operation, and then the follow-up. So, yeah.
Great.
This facility is important not only because of its local significance and its role in the city's approach to water resource management, it has also gained attention nationally. As an engineer, it's always exciting, and I know that's odd to use those two words together, exciting and engineering, to have the opportunity to work on innovative and interesting projects such as this one. It makes designing and implementing public works projects fun, quite frankly, as well as rewarding. But when we tell the story of the challenges and the limitations with our freshwater supplies here, they become very interested in the innovative things that are happening here in the Pacific Northwest. And this facility in particular has gained a lot of interest, with people from elsewhere taking notes of the design and the success of its operation. So this is definitely something for the cities to take pride in.
Olympia needed to move from a surface spring source to a nearby groundwater source to offset a real threat from their now former surface water source at McAllister Springs, from increased Safe Drinking Water Act treatment standards, and also really from in addition, a potential catastrophic train derailment at the nearby Burlington Northern Santa Fe rail tracks, where 40 to 50 trains pass by on a daily basis. Yelm also needed new water supplies to continue to provide drinking water for a growing city. The projected impact of these new water supplies would measurably impact flows in the Nisqually and Deschutes Rivers and in Woodland Creek here, and it would actually improve flows in McAllister Creek, which was a good mitigation credit for the three cities to take advantage of. But to offset those impacts to Woodland Creek, Lacey and Olympia, because that's where the main impacts are from those two cities, pooled resources, that's money and staff, to design, plan, construct this facility we're standing on today. Another progressive step in this groundwater recharge facility is that, in a nutshell, this facility is receiving treated wastewater and reintroducing it back to the groundwater aquifers beneath us, rather than, like most wastewater treatment facilities in Western Washington, discharging treated wastewater directly to Puget Sound. In effect, this treated wastewater is being reused again a second time to improve not only water levels in the aquifer beneath us, but to increase flows in Woodland Creek, basically from Martin Way north to Puget Sound. And that's good for the fish that migrate and spawn in Woodland Creek. So this is part of a long multi-year effort where three cities work together with each other, partnered with other agencies such as ecology and fish and wildlife, and collaborated with the interests of our nearby tribes, the Squaxin Island Tribe and the Nisqually Tribe, to achieve not only new water supplies for future needs, but also real physical facilities and habitat improvements to offset this impact in this area's water resources, so that our area's water supplies and stream flows in Woodland, McAllister Creeks, and the Nisqually and Deschutes River are protected. I believe this is the first time that such a shared teamwork between multiple cities has been utilized to address and solve a complex water resources challenge in our state.